Where the hell are we? No, you're so sneaky.
I couldn't find him. Could you?
He's such a sneaky little sneaker.
He hides too well. And if he was smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
You found me! Well done, Ryan.
Make him feel special. He's a fourthborn. He's useless.
Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
Me neither, man.
He was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asha. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and—
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
Yeah, in King's Landing though, I wouldn't lie to him.
To die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the wall. I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
He won't get hurt.
I don't know if he was either smart or strong, but...
No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Dude, I'm like 14.
They're worried about me.
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
Sir Roiland forgets himself. After all,
no, I'm gonna have him punished. Don't be a bitch.
I'll have him punished for saying that.
Oh, she didn't like that.
I don't know. But I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword. Like a man.
He fuck you saying.
Roderick and Asha, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
So you're saying my sister knows how to fight and I don't? Great form, kid. You're gonna be a world-class fencer one day.
Me, Roderick, Asha. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then, well, then everything changed.
Roderick, it's because the fucking fourthborn came along.
The Lord in training.
Goddamn Ryan ruined everything.
Smiled anymore. And Asha just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are. I know a lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like them. It's for you to decide for yourself.
I don't want to get angry, but I may have to. Father did sometimes.
But you're nice. Everybody says that about you.
He was known as Gregor the Good, and the man killed plenty of people. But listen, I gotta do what I gotta do.
You can do anything you want.
No, that's not how that works, man.
Everyone,
there are laws.
Say, so I could have all the sweets I want.
You're still gonna get diabetes.
It's that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted.
He's a kid. I'm not gonna tell him don't fool around.
Ethan will be a good lord, a proper lord.
That's not how it works.
Well, that's how it should work. You are the lord.
No, man. Absolute power corrupts absolutely. I wish I could tell you who said that, but I forgot.
You're needed in the great hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
Next time they boss me around, I'm gonna have their legs cut off.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced, and certainly unexpected.
I don't expect.
He's gone
nope.
Demanding justice.
Oh, he's gonna get justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us.
Sit the fuck down, little sister. All right.
He's demanding an
or twin sister, whatever.
We really must go.
It's
you're being
your
a
decision.
Dick.
You are the lord.
If I were lord, I would command Ethan to stay.
I'm gonna go because it's
fine. If that's what's required.
I mean, it is what I need to do.
Very well then.
He went that way. Why are you going that way? This doesn't make any sense. Follow him. You're going literally the opposite way. Are you avoiding your responsibilities? she's got cluster migraines.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained.
Is he gonna rinse?
Lord Ethan, why they're here?
A business with Garrod. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrod is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong. So don't give him any satisfaction.
Stop fucking being so angry all the time.
Now do it again with these bastards.
Alright.
Let's not do something rash.
I got this. I'm fucking like 13 years old, man.
Now is not the time.
I'm hot shit.
Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got five times as many men and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men
vote. Hey, you're right. She's got a silly ass haircut. I have no respect for him. Looks like a fat Will Ferrell.
Lord Ethan, is it? That's my condolences for your father and brother.
Nah, you don't mean that.
The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house, but to his family it's still a loss.
I'm like
shaking
his head.
Thank you, Lord Whitehill.
My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself.
You're a piece of shit.
I've been waiting for this day all my life.
I may be young, but I'm not so easily fooled. They're trying to rile me, but it won't work.
You're goddamn young. Right.
You are that boy. Too young to know when you're in over your head.
This boy's about to get the
and
hands.
Bread and salt. What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur.
It's literally my first day on the job.
I should have expected as much.
All right, I'll get you some fucking bread and salt.
Bread and salt. It was an oversight, Lord Whitehill. I promise it won't happen again.
Not likely. You foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have you back, are they? We're the power in the north now.
No, you're not. The Boltons. Yep. Thank you. Thank you.
And we've been his bannermen for five fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
We all serve House Bolton now.
I'm not finished. Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Don't fucking let your shares get taken. Simple. Oh, this fucking asshole. With a bowl cut. You're a grown man. What are you doing with a bowl cut?
Your man, the squire. We were minding our own business. Keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said.
It looks like he
when your man
character in Dumb and Dumber.
For no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
No reason? You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name.
We lost people too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
Goddamn right.
Those pig farmers, not soldiers. Soldiers worth 100 of their type.
That's no.
Where's the fucking coward who killed my men? I know he's here. What have you done with him?
We haven't seen him. He was never here.
You little liar. I will find him. By the gods, you better hope I do, because if I don't, I'm holding you responsible. And you'll answer for what he's done. I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton.
Oh, you need Roose Bolton to fight your battles, you little fat.
What kind of fucking house is this?
Little piggy.
A house of honorable men.
Oh, shit. Little piggy.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill.
That was the insult I was going for. I lost my words. That's way better.
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady.
Wounded boar, that's a good one. I gotta remember that one.
Losses and all. But this is not over.
It's over when my son says it is.
Thank you for coming, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say.
You're right.
Send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
We're in the right, Lord Whitehill. Remember that.
Mm-hmm. I would call him a craven, but I mean, that means coward. I'm not trying to stir some shit up. I know we're not in good standing right now with the Boltons. We don't really have much of a military.
Well, my lady.
So
he kept his wits while Lord Whitehill lost his temper. A lesser man would have been rattled, but Ethan here.
You were brave, my
son. I ain't no bitch.
But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee. Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once.
Yeah, because we need to get her the hell out of King's Landing. She's dead if she stays there. Ooh.
Your sister can help us. Although just a handmaiden, she has Marjorie Tyrell's favor. And Lady Marjorie's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay. If it's presented to her as it should be.
Got our own room in King's Landing. Ooh, a chest. Ooh, tome. I don't have time for such silly nonsense. I need to get down to business. I gotta save my house.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
Why does she look so sad? Come on, faster, 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 faster. Who's this?
One moment.
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you.
His voice is way deeper than it looks like it would be. I feel like I'm gonna get raped, but I feel like...
No, it's fine. Come in.
What are you looking at?
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you all right? If you don't mind my asking, you seem rather upset.
I'll let him know.
I'm just worried about my family.
Ah, letter from home, is it?
It's kind of you to ask.
Of course, m'lady. You've always been kind to me.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady. You work for Lady Marjorie?
Why are you asking so many questions, homie?
I may be wrong, but it seems like you do.
Okay.
I'm her handmaiden.
Let's play along.
That's what I thought. I've seen you.
What does he
before.
Want? Stop looking at me.
Good friends. I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Mm-hmm.
Cersei?
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but...
What did they
say? I need to know, man.
I couldn't make out much, but I know they were talking about the Starks and House Forrester.
House Forrester?
This kid's on to something.
I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. But I thought you ought to know. Most people don't tend to notice a call boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there.
This kid's about to be my spy.
Good night, m'lady.
Yeah, you need to eat some sandwiches, man. You are decaying. Goddamn.
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
It looks exactly like her.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss. From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own.
I don't think you do, though. You
what
say
you
that.
What you suffered is beyond imagining.
My family wrote me, my lady.
I don't doubt they must be overcome with grief.
Yeah, they need help.
But you must not
I should have just said that. I need help.
We will get through this together. You must understand.
Those are all just words. Why is she looking at us?
Say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark. It raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor.
Cersei paints everyone a traitor. Cersei wants everyone
she
dead.
Very pleased with herself.
I'm not a traitor.
Of course not.
I mean, your family
it's
kind
only
of
an
is.
Excuse to torment you, and by extension, me. She demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort. For what, I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important.
I have nothing
I
to apologize for.
I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
I cannot apologize, my lady. I'm not a traitor.
I know you're not, but you must find a way to appease her.
Her eyes just went wonky. Like, one of her eyes was way bigger than the other one there. What? Humor her. You can't humor Cersei. She's manipulative and evil and fuck you. She's a bitch. This is a lose-lose situation, man. Why does he look blue?
You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Okay. Well.
Good luck.
Okay. Okay, I'm worried. I'm about to get interrogated by Cersei.
You can do this.
Come on, let's get to it. Come on. There's a lot of noise. There aren't a whole lot of people in here. Like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There were whispers. Like, how many of them
Lady Marjorie.
Could have been whispering?
Aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion. Your Grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
God damn it. Do I kneel? Do I bow? Which one do I do? I'm gonna kneel.
Your Grace.
Oh, thank you.
The girl knows her courtesies. Impressive. You may rise.
Whew, thank God.
House Forrester.
That's a good note.
Is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Joffrey is the one true king, Your Grace.
And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark. A house of traitors.
They're not really traitors, though.
They were the Wardens of the North. We all served at the pleasure of the king.
Clever girl.
I'm not wrong. Hey, Tyrion likes me.
Good.
The girl did name Joffrey as the one true king.
I did do that.
Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Damn it. Okay, yeah.
Yes, Your Grace.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
I see. Despite the fact Roose Bolton allied with Walder Frey. If it was me, I'd find it difficult to so quickly forgive the men who killed my father.
Yeah, well, I'm being interrogated by the Queen, so...
Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies.
Okay.
I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose. But I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Absolutely.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Yes, Your Grace.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you?
Now she's fucking playing mind games.
And they do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
Yes, Your Grace. I would do anything.
Oh shit, I don't fucking like this at all.
I see.
So she's being that manipulative bitch.
What would you have the girl
do? I knew she was gonna do it.
It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
Tyrion Lannister, the voice of reason.
Interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I won't judge her, Your Grace. I wasn't there. I didn't face her decisions.
Aren't you a delightful girl? If only one could flit through life without ever holding an opinion of their own.
I mean, listen.
If there's a point to this, I hope
I'm not trying to get crucified.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts?
Okay.
You're a girl from the
there's
north,
still no argument here. Like, I need to understand why I'm being interrogated.
One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she
would... Let the girl answer the question. Go on.
I would be true to the king, Your Grace.
Well said. I was beginning to worry. You didn't have your priorities.
What do you mean, Margaery? She was the one who told me say things even if you feel the other way.
Crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's
Margaery was the one that told me to lie, and now she's getting upset.
My sense is this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants. Which is not very encouraging. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
Is there any way to, like, appease Cersei?
This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
These are trying times, my lord. My family fears what might happen now that the Boltons rule the north.
I need this dude's help.
They must still answer to the crown. You shouldn't forget that, nor should they. That certainly took courage. To so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Margaery was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased.
Cersei doesn't ever seem pleased.
It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all...
I'm gonna be honest with him.
I was trying to appease her.
I think that was clear to everyone. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can.
Yeah, absolutely.
She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters.
I'm pretty sure he's the master of coin.
The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard. Not her.
You can help my family.
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance. And it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that?
Dude, I'm willing to risk anything, not to have my family killed, so
it
yes.
Far too dangerous.
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion. Please.
You are a brave girl, aren't you? I'll consider it.
No, do it. Don't consider
now,
it.
If
just
you'll
do
excuse
it.
Me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
Thank you for the advice, Lord Tyrion.
Just be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Okay. When I found out that he was from New Jersey, Peter Dinklage is from New Jersey, I was just blown away. The guy has like the best accent on the show, and he's American. He's fascinating. Dude, now Marjorie's gonna come in here all pissed. No, that's Mira, not, what the fuck is this? Worried.
How was it?
Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing.
It's more than I kind of don't want to talk about it. I don't know what the fuck just happened.
If you don't mind. Of course not. It must have been horrible.
I feel like my mind was raped.
At least it's over now. Lady Marjorie has spent
dude,
the entire
why does she always like this girl always has a sad look on her face. I can't deal with it.
Of course, you and I are seated way at the back. Here with the fourth cousins and the ninth born sons. Ah, Sir Jaime, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Oh, okay, what? Bro, what's wrong with
it's
you?
True.
This is what girls
and
talk about.
Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour. Put it back.
Don't touch his shit.
Having a bit of fun.
It's Lady Marjorie's shit.
That's probably for the best. I've heard he's a bit perverse. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands.
Man, I don't give a fuck about getting married. I'm trying to save my house.
I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd...
Hell no. Fuck no.
He does have a certain look about him. And he's always treated like...
No, maybe for my family.
Which is more than you can say for his mother.
I'd marry anyone. If it helped my family.
Right. Of course.
We have different interests here. You're just trying to get fucked. I'm trying to save my family.
Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden.
Does she think she's being funny?
Let's see. Who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match. Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing?
He was touching that shit.
Well? Sarah?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display.
Thank God.
I'm just glad it's over.
I'm sorry I kind of betrayed you a little bit, but you kind of told me to.
King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes.
No, what? Who the fuck?
Someone
don't call me.
Or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am Queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
I wasn't really listening. Yes.
Once you are queen, the lords and ladies will do their best to please you.
You learn very quickly. You were brave agreeing to obey the Boltons. That cannot have been easy. I know you must fear what Lord Bolton might do to your family.
Yes, because Ramsay is
I
a fucking psychopath.
Your willingness to appease her.
Who cut a man's dick off?
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind.
Something he basically made a man a pet. That's terrifying. I need some help.
I.
Excuse me.
Give you in
excuse me.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
All right, if she says so.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
All right, no, she can stay. I don't care.
Go on. Ask.
Fuck. Stop, Ramsay.
Please, Ramsay Snow is on his way to Ironwrath to see my brother bend the knee.
Ramsay? Roose Bolton's bastard.
That's
I
the
think
one.
My family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes.
Yep, probably.
But if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown.
Please.
That is no small request. Especially now. Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks. And now you would have me ask him to intervene.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm asking.
Is the situation that dire?
Yeah.
You can't, my lady.
The fuck?
King Joffrey won't like it. Just think how he turned on Lady Sansa. It is that dire, my lady.
I fucking trusted you, I let you stay, and you're gonna fucking argue against me, you fucking bitch. Shut the fuck up. You're in my room. I think.
I don't know, Mira. If Cersei were to find out...
Don't let the Queen bully you. You have power over him, Lady Margaery, as no one else does. Not even his mother.
This is gonna backfire. I fucking know it.
Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
I don't know why I let this bitch stay. She was fucking trying to sabotage my plans. That horse has like pure black eyes. That is terrifying. Shut up. Alright, it's gone.
Seven elves.
Oh, this is not good.
Let's play a little game, shall we? Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat?
Yeah, someone's for sure gonna die.
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy. What with all that bloody noise?
Like a droning cat.
Peeking around his corner.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets. But the flayed man holds none.
This is fucked, man.
Father is the Warden of the North.
He does now.
There's no doubt that someone's gonna die once he gets to Forrester or Ironwrath or whatever.
A day, my lord. Two at most.
Yep, someone's dead for sure.
What is that?
My lord?
Shh. Listen.
Uh-oh.
There. Hear that? I know I heard something.
Don't run. They have horses. You sit your ass still.
Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
Okay, thank God. Running, I think, would have been the dumbest choice possible. They have horses. I don't know how I'm gonna outrun them. The dude would literally flay me alive. He'd wear my fucking dick as a condom. I don't want to see this. Why are we walking at this? I don't want to see this. Okay. God.
Bloody hell.
Look at his pec development. Yeah, I had great pecs. You look dehydrated, my man. You need to get some hydration. Some electrolytes in your body. Bacon. Live bacon. Is there a sprint? Oh, I can walk a little faster. I gotta be careful, he's low on electrolytes. Oh, that's a dead pig. They're overcooking the bacon.